click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ekeeda.
Hello friends, till now we have seen the rolling process, how it is classified and how it is done. Now we will see another part, which is the defects. What are rolling defects and how it can be avoided? So I'll talk about rolling defect. Mill spring defect is the major defects which comes in rolling. It generally happens due to the thickness variation of the material. If your material is more thick or less thick than the prescribed thickness which is it is supposed to be, mill spring defects occurs. So again, it goes like this. The deflection can be achieved, but the rolling forces would be high. So the next defect which we can talk about is misalignment. Misalignment generally occurs when your rolls are not in a proper position. For that, you need to check your stands. Your roll material should have high elastic modulus. It should not be less, or it should not be as per your prescribed requirement. So it also plays a very important role. If your material to be rolled is very thin, so again we can't use it in a rolling process. So these are some general defects which can occur before or during your rolling process. Also, edges can crack during rolling. It can be zippy, it can be edge. So during your rolling process, your material is passing through the roll, its edges can crack due to high and low pressure. So this can be prevented by chamfering the rolls. So in this diagram you can see there is a wavy crack and there is a zipper crack. Both the edges crack in the different ways. It generally happens due to high or low pressure or improper feeding of your roll. Also, now you can see in the presentation there is a center crack part. It occurs again due to improper pressure, and also there is an edge cracking. It also occurs due to improper pressure. So as I want to say, pressure plays a very important role in rolling, as well as feeding how your material is fed between your rollers. So now I'll talk about this kind of defect. This kind of defect generally occurs when your edges of your roll are more convex. You don't need a convexity at the end of your part, but your edges are convex just because of the roller. So it occurs when your rollers are not at a proper position or your rollers are not fit to roll that particular object. So to avoid rolling defects, thickness of the material should be maintained. If the thickness is less, rolling cannot be done in a proper position. Again, with thickness comes the pressure. Pressure should be handled properly. Like, because of that, your edges or center may burst. So pressure is also an important factor. Then we'll go one by one to the other factors. Your sheet also try to tend to the other direction. Like, it laterally tries to get into other direction due to friction. So because of that, also defect can occur. So I'll talk about non-homogeneous material deformation, stress induced and flow of work. Non-homogeneity plays a very important role. If the material is not homogeneous, it is not at a proper content, like composition is not proper, rolling won't take place properly. Also, the direction of feed, like your flow of material, should be unidirectional. More or less speed may hamper your rolled product. So during rolling, compressive deformation occurs at the center due to that center burst occurred, but it is also a void making process and it creates a defect. So these are some general rolling defects. Thank you for watching this video. Stay tuned with Ekeeda and do subscribe our channel Ekeeda.